Orlando Magic forward Jonathan Isaac was the only player standing during the
anthem. You didn't kneel during the anthem, but you also didn't wear a Black Lives Matter shirt. Do you believe that Black Lives Matter?
The moment when you find yourself standing alone like I did, even though I knew deep down that I wasn't alone, in the actual reality of it, I was. It was scary, it was lonely. Anybody who is gonna be going through that, I think there's a foundational understanding that they are standing up for something bigger than themselves. And at the end of the day, if they're standing on truth, then they should go through with it. And for me, I wanted to point people to Christ.
He got it! Isaac on the rebound and the follow. Jonathan Isaac can do no wrong right now.
For me, UNITUS is about action. We know all these things are going on. We talk about it to a blue in the face. Cancel culture, these values that are being pushed that we know are moving farther and farther away from godly values, constitutional values. But for me, the answer is action. I think the biggest issue in our country today is just how polarized everything has become. You're not allowed to speak. You're not allowed to differ in any way from the mainstream narrative. And people feel like they don't have an outlet, they can't speak their minds, and that now their values and what they believed in, what's helped their families get to where they are today, are no longer valid. Especially in my sphere of influence when it comes to sportswear, leisure wear, I see the problem. And with UNITUS, I'm trying my best to offer a high quality, culturally relevant solution to parents, to young adults, to kids on college campuses. UNITUS is for you. I want to take values like faith, family, and freedom and give you encouragement and power to stand on those values, know that they're valid, and express them in what you wear. And that's what UNITUS is about for me. Cancel culture is negative because it speaks to this kind of wayward definition of tolerance. People want you to be tolerant of their values and their beliefs and what they feel is right for them, but they don't want to be tolerant to what you have to say or what you believe in. That's what I reject. I think that in order to have a prosperous society, we have to be able to talk, we have to be able to debate and speak our minds freely. And at the end of the day, you have to be able to trust in and stand on your values, no matter what anybody says. Even if they come after you, even if they cancel you, your values are your values, and you should be freely able to do so. I think an organization like YAF is important because they're giving kids and young adults, especially kids on college campuses, that diversity of thought and a different way of thinking about the outlook on our country, the outlook of life, spirituality, all these different things. I think YAF embodies all of that, and it's needed. We need alternatives to mainstream media, and what other outlet is speaking the kind of things that YAF is on college campuses outside of already conservative leading outlets? My advice to any kids on college campuses, high school kids, even middle school, because there's, you know, a lot of things that are going on in our society that are facing pushback and hostility for the things that they believe, get around people that believe and think like you do. I know that's something that's really difficult, especially if you're the only one, but community is so important, and finding people of like mind makes you stronger, and you encourage each other to stand up for what you guys believe in. If I didn't have the right people around me, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing. I wouldn't be the person or the man that I am today. I give God the credit because I believe that I have a purpose on this earth, and that is to bring forth the kingdom of heaven, be a vessel, and continue to just fight for that. You're needed. You are needed. Your voice is needed. What you believe is needed. What we believe is needed, especially as we catch all of this pushback and other ideologies and values are pushed to the forefront. If we stop talking, if we stop leading, if we stop innovating and creating, then at the end of the day, they'll continue to advance, and the only answer for us in time is going to be to conform. Standing is only going to get harder, but only the more necessary. It's something that we have to do in order to make our voices heard and to rally the other people who probably do believe like us, but don't have the courage in the moment to do so. Let's take back a lot of the ground that's being lost.